This is the third in our series of videos about techniques for diagonalizing matrices. In this one video, we're going to talk about block diagonal and block triangular matrices. So a block triangular matrix is something of this form. We can divide it into blocks, and this is what we call upper block triangular. This is what we call lower block triangular. You divide it into, there's a square block, and either only the upper part counts or only the lower part counts. The rest is zero. If this is what we call block diagonal. There's an upper left block, there's a lower right block, and everything else is zero. Let's make that a little bit more precise. In general, we're going to look at partition matrices. We want a partition matrix where A and D are square and B and C can be rectangular. Okay. A block is block upper triangular if C is zero, if these are A, B, and D are the only things that contribute. It's block lower triangular if B is zero, if A, C, and D are the only things that contribute. And it's block diagonal if B is 0 and C is 0. Now, what's so great about all of these cases is in all of these cases, the problem of finding eigenvalues of this big matrix reduced to studying the matrix A and the matrix D. In all of the cases, the eigenvalues of the big matrix are just the eigenvalues of A together with the eigenvalues of D. That's a lot simpler. Small matrices are easier to handle than big matrices. And the characteristic polynomial of the big matrix is the product of the characteristic polynomials of A and D. So if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then PA of lambda is 0. Well, that makes PM of lambda 0. If lambda is an eigenvalue of D, then PD of lambda is 0, and so PM of lambda is 0. So let's walk through the cases one at a time and see why this works. The simplest case by far is when you have things that are block diagonal. So B and C are 0, and we just have an A in the upper left and a D in the lower right. Then if we try to compute the characteristic polynomial, lambda I minus M is you're going to get the identity minus A here and the identity minus D here. Now, these identities are different sizes. If this is a 3x3 block and this is a 5x5 block, then this is the 3x3 identity, this is a 5x5 identity, this is an 8x8 identity. And I'm not going to write subscripts to tell you the size of the identities. When you take the determinant of this, the determinant of the left-hand side, that's the characteristic polynomial of M, is this determinant times this determinant. Well, this determinant is the characteristic polynomial of A, and this determinant is the characteristic polynomial of D. So there we have our factorization of the characteristic polynomial, and that's what tells you the eigenvalues of A and D are eigenvalues of M. But it's more than eigenvalues. It's also eigenvectors. If you have an eigenvector of A, then you can pad it with zeros to get an eigenvector of M. See, if you multiply A00D by X0, you get AX upstairs, and you get D times 0 downstairs, and that just gives you lambda X0, which is lambda times X0. Great, it's an eigenvector. And likewise, if you have an eigenvector of D, we'll call the eigenvalue mu instead of lambda, just because we've already used lambda. Then you pad it upwards, and A00D times 0y gives you 0dy, and that's 0 mu y, which is mu times 0y. So block diagonal is really simple. The eigenvalues of A and D of M are the eigenvalues of A and D. The eigenvectors of M are easily built from the eigenvectors of A and D. Now, block triangular is a little, let's work an example. In this example, we have a 5x5 matrix, but we break it down into a 2x2 matrix and a 3x3 matrix. The 2x2 matrix is of a form we recognize. It's our favorite matrix with eigenvalues 3 and 1, and its eigenvectors are 1, 1, and 1, negative 1. We've also seen the 3x3 matrix before. Its eigenvalues are 2, negative 1, and negative 1, which is to say they're 2 and negative 1, but negative 1 is a double root. And the eigenvectors are 1, 1, 1, negative 1, 1, 0, and negative 1, 0, 1. So that means that the eigenvalues of the whole matrix are these eigenvalues and these eigenvalues. And you get the eigenvectors of the whole matrix. You get two of them by taking the eigenvectors of A and padding them with zeros. And you get the other three by taking the eigenvectors of D and padding them on the top with zeros. So block diagonal is pretty simple. Block triangular is a little bit tougher. If something is block triangular, then you still have the factorization of the characteristic polynomial. See, if you have a matrix like this, it's still true that the determinant of this big matrix is the determinant of this corner times the determinant of this corner. And that's enough to get you the characteristic polynomial of M. It's the characteristic polynomial of A times that of D. What's more is if you have eigenvectors of A, you can still pad them with zeros to get eigenvectors of the big matrix. See, at the top you get AX plus B0, which is AX. And at the bottom, you get 0x plus d times 0, and that's 0. However, you cannot pad things the other way. If you find an eigenvector of d, then 0 followed by that eigenvector is typically not an eigenvector of m. Because if you multiply it out, at the top, you get a times 0 plus b times y. That's not 0. That's not a multiple of 0. You get 0 times 0 plus d times y. That part works. But this is not a multiple of 0y, because the top term is by. So the b gets in the way of extending the eigenvector. The eigenvectors of A extend nicely. The eigenvectors of D don't. The eigenvalues are fine, but if you want to find the eigenvectors, you have to sweat. You have to actually write m minus lambda times the identity, row reduce, and do all that work to get the eigenvectors. So for example, this is an upper triangular matrix. It's got an upper left block, which is 2, 3, 3, 2, and it's got a lower right block, which is just the number 4. It's a 1 by 1 matrix. So from the 2, 3, 3, 2, we've seen that whenever you have a matrix of the form A, B, B, A, you get eigenvalues that are A plus or minus B. So that's 2 plus 3 and 2 minus 3. And the eigenvectors are 1, 1, and 1 minus 1. Well, the 1 by 1 matrix, well, the eigenvector is 1 and the eigenvalue is the number in it. It's already diagonal. So if you take the eigenvectors of the top matrix and pad them with zeros, you get eigenvectors of the 3 by 3. You multiply this by 1, 1, 0, you get 2 plus 3 plus 0, that's 5. 3 plus 2 plus 0, that's 5. 0 plus 0 plus 0, that's 0. It works. It's 5 times 1, 1, 0. And likewise, if you plug in 1, negative 1, 0, you get an eigenvector with eigenvalue negative 1. However, if you try multiplying by 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 3, 2, 7, 0, 0, 4. If you multiply that by 0, 0, 1, take the eigenvector of D and pad it upwards, you get 5, 7, 4, which is not 4 times 0, 0, 1. So if you want to find the eigenvector with eigenvalue 4, and there is one, you have to go ahead and you have to write down the matrix minus 4 times the identity. And then you have to go through the whole long song and dance of row reduction, and you get these really ugly fractions, and you discover that the eigenvector is minus 31 fifths, minus 29 fifths, 1. Much harder. So it can be done, but it takes work. If something is block lower triangular, it works the same as block upper triangular, except the roles of A and D are reversed. You still have that the eigenvalues of M are the eigenvalues of A times the eigenvalues of D. And if you have an eigenvector of D, now you can pad it upwards. But if you have an eigenvector of A, you cannot pad it downwards. The eigenvalues of A are eigenvalues of M, but you have to work hard to figure out what the eigenvectors are.